Here we go.
Activating combat mode.
Thousand scenes right in the beginning to skip.
Once registered. Now that
I'm doing this offline, even though I normally stream over at twitch.tv/flufflehusky. Always forget that. I would do myself such a big favor if I didn't forget that.
Activating combat mode. Conflict resolved.
Okay.
Activating combat mode.
Out of the way.
I keep hitting triggers.
Conflict resolved.
Player there was much faster. That was a good call, John.
Activating combat mode. Conflict resolved.
Liking these materia choices.
Activating combat mode.
Well, when you hit them. Quake everything.
Activating combat mode.
If it exists, quake it.
Resolved.
My motto. I've literally never said that until right now.
Activating combat mode. Conflict resolved.
The double cast is gonna kill me though. Alright, I'm gonna have to start swinging like normal.
Activating combat mode.
Not me trying to cast Quake anyway. I think double cast might have been a bad choice for a materia, but whatever at this point. It'll probably be useful later.
Activating combat mode.
Zach, let's...
Activating combat mode. Conflict resolved.
And...
Activating combat mode. Conflict resolved.
No way. Oh, holy. Keep trying to pause there and skip that, even though it's not a cutscene.
Activating combat mode.
Really? Just slightly out of range? Try not to hit that second one, if that's even what a second one is. I find myself not really able to remember it, interestingly enough.
Activating combat mode.
Right, there's a combat. To bump into the mic.
Activating combat mode.
Bring it on.
Conflict resolved.
Oh yeah.
I don't really have a whole lot to say as I'm doing this run. Nothing really particularly interesting other than I'm just trying to get a good time on hard new game plus, any percent. If I think of anything enlightening. Other than Quake and Flare have been an absolute joy to use up to this point. I get this little encounter. Or I always pause just a second too late. Oh, really? The split times that you see at the bottom right of the screen are based on my first ever run in normal. I haven't done a hard mode run yet. And I've only completed the one run so far just because the other ones have been attempts or practices or whatever. Something went horribly wrong and I had to restart. So realistically, it's only my second run that I will be completing. Kind of regardless of what happens. Excuse me. This shelling scenario, I'm gonna try to hit all except the last one, just so I don't have to see the perfect bonus at the end. 'Cause you get like the gill or whatever. But if you do it perfectly, like all 10 of them, then you have to look at the 500 gil pop-up message up here, and it's just wasted time. I don't really know if getting hit by them or just outright slashing them, like which one's faster, so I just hit all 9 and then get hit by the last one. Or at the very least, try to do that. Ew. I always forget where you can skip. As soon as Song starts talking. It's after that 900 gil that you'll get the perfect bonus of 500. It doesn't just lump it all together. Ah, doesn't hit him. That's why you don't use it. So you're like, why don't I just use Quake? Because Quake doesn't hit him. Excuse me. I'll be using Hammer Punch a little later on in the run, just because it deals the most amount of damage. Wait, did I do the wrong thing? I did. I hit the wrong button. Yeah, it'll ultimately save me a little time towards the end of the game when things need to be just hit very hard.
Activating combat mode. Conflict resolved.
now since we get MP back for the end of each battle. You get over here. I'm gonna get a memory. So unlucky. Now we get MP back at the end of each fight, so we don't have to worry about stopping at checkpoints anymore, which is nice.
Activating combat mode. Calling result.
Oop, not a cutscene. This is a cutscene. There's gonna be certain encounters here that we're just gonna run away from because it's faster to run away than to try to spell kill. Especially since our only spell right now is Flare, and that takes a minute. By a minute, I mean it takes time. Not actual minute. Like right now. Kill him and then run away from the rest of them. Kill him because otherwise he'll poke us in the butt and we lose that time spent trying to run away. Two encounters here. One we ignore, the other we kill. Sephiroth, gotta go to the lowest point. There's two encounters here, too. Nope, it's the one. Ooh. Thought the camera was supposed to turn around there, but it didn't. I still have a lot of cleanup to do with my movements and whatnot. My actions. I have a lot of cleanup to do, but
activating combat mode. Calling result.
God, I hate getting caught on these corners, especially when it doesn't matter. How's Zach, a super enhanced super soldier, can't catch up with Hollander here? Will never make sense to me. Decent time. Hello. Really stiff today. Not that that's really relevant. Oh, shit. I keep trying to skip transitions. One of these days I will learn. Today is not that day.
Hey, wait.
Then I can talk to everyone. Where am I going? I'm going the not right way, but whatever. I basically went the long way there. Feels bad, but it is what it is. I get so turned around.
I have to...
Let's go to the park. Right now. Damn it. Thought I had one more cutscene for some reason. Guess I was expecting Song to show up. I'm busy. Yeah, whatever. Oh yeah, Quake here is going to be very helpful. Except for when I get put up against enemies that can't be affected by Quake. That's when it becomes a problem. Just steps slightly out of my range. I don't think I've ever hit an encounter there, ever, until right now. Love that for me. Go ahead and boop him right in the duker, you know? Go try to see Aerith, and we'll go to get Nibelheim, or Medeoheim. See if we can get the first try sneak away from the guards. Absolute worst try. Just keep doing it until they go away, which would suck. But we're gonna try to not suck. Such a big ass waste of time. But what are you gonna do? Just give her a phone call, I guess. I went the long way. And it's just a weird way that the camera sets up. I have to remember to turn around there and not go the long way. The long way is not that much longer, but it's long enough that it's annoying. And like when I drive home and I miss my turn, so I have to take the long way. It's really not that much longer. It's just annoying. Alright, let's see if we can skip the majority of the encounters here. That'd be just great. That would be ducky. So far, so good. And of course, because I want to make sure that I do the skip rate the first time, I practiced it exactly 0 times before actually doing the run. So we'll see. I say skip. It's not really a skip. It's just quickly getting around the guards here. You'll see. It's going to be so good. I actually skipped all the encounters here. So far, so good. That guy's blind. First try. Actual first try, too. Pretty excited about that, actually. My run attempt in here earlier, I ended up resetting because I hit every single guard and I was just annoyed by it. I didn't even know that was a thing until I was trying to brute force it, and then I like looked up how to do it properly. Meant to punch, but whatever. Quake works too. Try to dodge these encounters. What I mean by dodging encounters, if you don't know what I'm doing, is running around the outside edge of most encounters. You won't trigger an encounter. You'll just skirt around it, basically. It's a trick used, not here. It's a trick used for a lot of like missions, if you're not fully familiar with the game, where you don't have to get every single encounter in every single mission, basically. That's the spot. It turns me around. Song. Dude. Of all the things to have collision, Song's legs. Yeah, so if you just skirt around the outside, wherever there's encounters, for the most part, you'll be able to just skirt right by them. So, if you didn't know that, now you do. And you're welcome.
Activating combat mode.
I guess I could have just slashed instead of punched twice, but what can I do? Fight's over.
Hey.
Little vacay. Little R&R never hurt anyone. I haven't seen much about chapter 6 yet, where I don't know what all I can skip or what all I can ignore if I can just move on. Encounters here, not really as much, can't really skip them as much, but there's like the, you have to dodge, or you have to defend the gate against like 30 whatevers. There we go. Quake's still working. I imagine Quake will end up working for the most part, and I can realistically even ignore using my Buster Sword as just general damage anyway, I'm assuming. Oh shit, wait. I was sitting there waiting for the cutscene to start. Should have just punched. It's a bummer. Oh well. Spot for potential time save in the future then. Yep, here we go. We have to defeat 30 enemies. And the big orb dudes, of course, don't get hurt by... Activating combat mode. We'll do a flare this time. Conflict resolved. Oh, yeah. The big orb dudes don't get hurt by my ground type move. And I honestly think flare is still going to be faster than hitting them a bunch with the sword. That's what I'm doing. What I'm doing. Oop, there you are. There's nothing behind me, right? No. Okay, good. Activating combat mode. It would have been awkward if there was just something behind me and I had to like redo the whole thing or whatever. Activating combat mode. Conflict resolved. Activating combat. There almost was something behind me. I think that's 30. No, one more. There you are. Activating combat mode. There's 30. Oh, yeah. Resolved. All right. What am I stuck? Oh my god, are you kidding me? That button has... That elevator button has collision. I can appreciate it. You wouldn't want to jam your elbow into it. Into a... Like, wire or anything like that, but...
Activating combat mode.
I'm done with that. Hammer punch. Costly punch is really good, too. But, hammer punch.
Yay, the flower wagon quest.
My favorite, I lied. I still have to build all the better flower wagons on my not speedrun file. Helmet. Next one is tools. Why does it even give you an option? Like, why does it give you the option to check to see? Should I look at it? Yeah. Duh. What do you mean? Like, obviously I want you to look at that. That's why I ran up to it. Really a non-issue at the end of the day. I'm just bitching for the sake of bitching. Seventh Heaven.
Good job.
Wheels. I appreciate that it at least tells you where to look for the items in this. I mean, not that it's super hard. There's not a lot of locations, but one of the things I noticed from the PSP version to this version is like, hey, the item you're looking for is going to be over here. And like, you still have to look for it, but I don't know, a little quality of life thing. Wheels. And now the plans, which are back in that first soldier helmet we found. I'm going the long way around. Did it again. One thing I will give this this game is the music. I mean, there's a lot I'll give this game, but the music especially, very good. So could it... All right, let's go build that wagon.
Oop. Welcome back, Zach.
Come on.
Wow.
All the like dialogues and whatnot you can skip throughout the game. I forgot that I whenever we get to this chapter, I always forget that we have like we're just at the church to see Aerith, and now we have to go back to the church to see Aerith. Constantly forget. It just seems like such a weird need for me to run. I don't know. I was just thinking like it could have been just a cutscene, you know, and not make me have to run all the way back. But it is what it is. Another chance to run around and get side quests, I guess. At least it's not far. Like if you had if the distance between the church and the Shinra building were super far apart, then it would just kind of be ass.
Thanks for.
Now, as we're getting to a part where I guess my knowledge of what I'm supposed to be doing gets a little fuzzy, so this might be a little sloppy, but as I do more and more runs of this, it'll be less sloppy. Oop, ran right past you. Now this one we kind of have to, I don't know, can you skirt around them? Never tried. Let's try. Skirt? Oh, you can. Okay, that's helpful, actually. Oh, can't skirt around that one. Actually, there might not even there might not have been any encounters there. No, I think there are a couple of encounters we are skirting past.
Activating combat mode.
It's not this one.
Oh, yeah. Resolved.
Nibelheim. Quick little chit chat from Aerith.
Aerith.
My run before, I forgot to grab the key, the dresser key, so I had to go all the way back down. So we're gonna try to not forget to grab that. And I think because I'm like cognitively thinking about it now, I probably won't miss it, but it is one of those things that I just, you know? Oop, leave. The day Sephiroth goes insane.
Combat mode.
Oh, yeah.
Resolved.
Oh, yeah.
Doing significantly more damage now with the Buster Sword. Or at least it feels like it. Boop! You want him a booty? There's a run I saw on speedrun.com that's like 55 minutes. I mean, it was on normal difficulty, not that the difficulties really made a difference here at all, but no idea how I did it. Pausing at inappropriate times probably isn't the way to do it though.
Activating combat mode.
Oops. Wow, that was almost really bad. Come on. I'm out of mana. Oh my god, I can't believe I died. I ran out of mana because I was casting too fast. Whoops. Unlucky.
Activating combat mode.
There we go. That's better. One death, unfortunate. But such is the life of hard mode.
You call.
Oops. Alright, grab the key. Nope. Nope, where's the guy? You, grab the key. So the timer ends for the particular run. It starts when you pick your difficulty, and the timer actually ends on your last hit on the final Genesis fight. You don't have to go through the actual emotional damage part. So. Where are we? I have no idea why I got so turned around there, but that was rough. Nope, not the room. Remember how I said this last part's gonna look a little sloppy? Welcome to the last part.
Activating combat mode.
Out of the way.
So. Grab that for later. I say for later, but it's something we actually have to do for poor Cloud. Mm-hmm. Sir, excuse me. That's my cloud. Thank you. Completely unnecessary. There you go. Now you're a soldier first class, just like me.
Activating combat mode.
What are you doing? Yep, don't care. Everyone can escape. It's fine. I'm not in the market of killing things. Well, that's a lie. Today I'm not. One of the big, like, last things in chapter 10 is finding all of the goddess materia. I don't know the fastest way to do that yet, but we'll see. Not anywhere near you. Oh my god. They are aggressive. Gongaga. Oops.
Is it activating combat
mode? I just tried to skip combat. Skip the combat scene. Gotta run right now. Oh, this game doesn't have waypoints? Unplayable. Bring back the unplayable memes. So good. Yeah, up. Wait, where the hell am I? Pay attention to the game, Musk.
Excuse me.
So. Dumb apples.
Here we go.
Activating combat mode.
Bring it on.
No. Don't want the Howling Fane. That's a whole different ball game. Just one down there, and then there's three in here. Cool. And then the last one is around here. Shit, they're right there. Okay. I feel like this would be a really nice place to, like, relax, you know, not having to deal with world-ending shit, but just feels like the water would be nice and really nice temperature. Air would be a really good, you know, cool but not too cold. Oop, get down there.
Activating combat mode.
Ooh, hello. Come on, come on, come on. Hey, where's for me? Okay, let's do this.
My soul.
A lot of health. Nope, didn't need to use flare. Just trying to punch. Trying to punch my problems away. Come on. Oh, you're kidding. No, pay attention to the sword. Are you serious? Oh, I'm so mad, actually. unlucky. Oh, man. You run from me. No. Stop.
Conflict resolved.
Hey. 108.35 world record.
Nice. Hey.
I gotta tell John.
I'm excited about that.
And you know what? There's room for improvement on that too. I'm sure I could equip another materia that would make the Genesis fight just so much easier. But wow. Anyway, Crisis Core Reunion, hard mode, new game plus, any percent. I'm going to go check speedrun.com just to make sure before I overhype myself up. But I'm pretty sure that's current world record. New game, any percent, hard, console 60. That's really awesome. I'm really excited. Thank you guys for watching. If you watch this, I stream on twitch.tv/flufflehusky. I usually stream Tuesdays and Fridays, sometimes Mondays or whenever I feel like it. So only scheduled days are Tuesdays and Fridays though, but that's it. We will try this run again later. I'm so fucking stoked, dude.
Yay.
Yay.